This is Gunde Svan of Sweden. He lives in the small village of Vansbro, some 250 kilometers northwest of Stockholm. As the 1988 Calgary Winter Olympics approach, 26-year-old Gunde Svan is considered by many the greatest male cross-country skier in history. 4 years earlier, at the Sarajevo Olympics, Svan competed in all four events and stood on the victory platform four times, the winner of two gold, one silver, and one bronze medal. Now, here in Calgary, there are more lavish predictions. Some believe that Gunde Svan can win gold medals in all four events, the 15, 30, and 50 kilometer races, and is a member of the 4x10 kilometer relay team, which will once again face the challenge of the Soviet Union, whom they defeated 4 years earlier in Sarajevo.
You don't go on skis to be second or third, you go for to win, and I feel it like if I don't win, it's a loss.
Cross-country skiing is a way of life in Sweden. For more than 4,000 years, Scandinavians have skied for survival, hunting for food, and as a means of transportation. For Swedish children, walking and skiing are synonymous.
I began when I was 3 years old. I think it was fun, and I began to ski seriously when I was 15, 16 years, and my uncle and my father support me, especially with skis, and my father built skis for me in the first time, and my mother drive me to the races and so on in the beginning.
Ironically, one of the great influences in Gunde Svan's career was an American, Bill Koch, who at the 1976 Innsbruck Olympics became the first and only American to win a cross-country medal.
And my mother wanted to meet with Bill at a photo, and then when I stay there, I look up to Bill and look for him. It was so big, and it was like a bear, and I feel me so very small, and I was small. But now in Overstorf, we do it the same way, but now I was the big bear, and Billy was a little bit smaller now, so. So he feel that, yeah, now it was changed.
That was a neat moment because Gunde was, I guess, 13 at that time, and so it probably was a special thing for him to have a picture there. And 8 years later, he came back to get me, and he was definitely another head taller than I was back then.
Cross-country skiing is the most grueling event on the Winter Olympic program. Like the marathoner, the cross-country skier has many adversaries to overcome. The weather, the terrain, the competition, and perhaps most of all, oneself. To compete at a world-class level, the skier must combine tactics with speed and strength. To win, he must have the ability to endure. February 15, 1988. The first of the men's races. The 30-kilometer event, approximately 19 miles. The race is decided by the fastest time. The order of racers is chosen by lot. Starting with number one, each skier will be sent off at 30-second intervals. 91 men are entered. Gunde Svan will start in the 82nd position. His late start is an advantage. His main opposition will already be on the course, and he will know the time he has to beat. Before he begins, he will receive valuable information from coaches and teammates concerning weather conditions, texture of the snow, and proper wax for his skis. Many times, the outcome of a race can be determined hours before the competition begins. Then, early in the morning, skiers and coaches test different waxes. The wrong choice is often the difference between victory and defeat. One by one, the skiers go off. The numerical order of the skiers permits each one to know how well he is doing. He immediately knows whether he is passing or being passed by skiers based on the start number he is wearing. Approximately 40 minutes after the first skier goes off, It is time for Gunde Svan. 4 years earlier in this event, he finished third behind two Soviet skiers who won the gold and silver medals. One third into the course, 10 kilometers, it is apparent that this will not be Gunde Svan's day. He is in 12th place, more than 40 seconds behind the leader. As the race continues, his position is deteriorating. At 20 kilometers, he is now more than 2 minutes behind. The race is going no better for Torgny Mogren, Svan's teammate. Mogren and Svan have skied together since they were children, and prior to Calgary, Mogren was leading Svan for World Cup supremacy. At the finish, the top honors go to Soviet and Norwegian skiers. Alexei Prokhorov, Soviet Union first. Vladimir Smirnov, Soviet Union second. Vegard Ulvang, Norway third. Gunde Svan finishes 10th, and Torgny Mogren right behind him in 11th place. 4 days later, the 15 kilometers. Gunde Svan is defending Olympic champion. Again, he has an excellent starting position. He will go out 84th in a field of 92 skiers. His teammate, Torgny Mogren, is also entered in the race. As the race progresses, it appears to be a duplicate of the 30 kilometers. Again, the race is dominated by Soviet and Norwegian skiers, the same countries that won the medals in the previous race. Mikhail Devityarov of the Soviet Union is the winner, followed by Paul Mikkelsplace of Norway. In third place, Vladimir Smirnov of the Soviet Union, adding a bronze to the silver he won in the 30 kilometers. Svan and Mogren do not make the top 10. Svan finishes 13th. Mogren, 24th. There is depression in the Swedish camp. With two events left, they have been shut out of the medals. All six have been won by Soviet and Norwegian skiers.
What was happening in the first races is that the Swedes were not as well prepared for those games as the Soviets were. The Soviets had been training for months and months at the exact same altitude as Calgary was, and on the same types of courses, and they had been staying more in their own country, competing against themselves, and actually, the competitive level, the overall depth of competition inside of the Soviet Union itself is probably higher than the entire World Cup circuit with all nations competing. The Swedes, on the other hand, were competing on the World Cup, and they had not had a lot of base of altitude training when they came into Calgary. Ladies and
gentlemen, welcome to the Monday, February 22nd, the 4x10 kilometer relay, the most exciting event in cross-country skiing. Four men from each country skiing 10 kilometers in head-to-head competition. The first team to cross the finish line is the winner. There is more national pride attached to this race than any other event on the winter program, particularly for the Swedish team. They are defending Olympic champions. Three members of the team, which won the gold medal 4 years ago in Sarajevo, are back again. Gunde Svan, Jan Ottosson, and the legendary 31-year-old Tomas Vassberg, competing in his fourth Olympics and fourth cross-country relay race. Vassberg, too, is a Swedish hero, the winner of three gold medals in previous Olympics. Completing the team, 24-year-old Torgny Mogren. There is a change in the Swedish lineup. Gunde Svan will ski third and Torgny Mogren fourth, the anchor leg. 4 years ago in Sarajevo, Gunde Svan skied the anchor leg and came from behind to defeat his Soviet opponent. The race begins. Swedish coach Lars Göran Pettersson has decided on new tactics from 4 years before. Jan Ottosson will lead off, followed by Vossberg with Gunde Svan skiing third. Coach Pettersson wants his first two skiers to stay even with the leaders in the first half of the race. Then it will be up to Gunde Svan to break open the race on the third leg and give a commanding lead to Mogren. It is determined that if Svan can give Mogren a 20 to 30 second lead, there is nothing the Soviets can do to deprive them of a victory. In theory, the strategy is simple. The execution of it will be difficult. Opposing Gunde Svan on the third leg will be Mikhail Dibitiarov of the Soviet Union, who earlier won the gold medal in the 15 kilometers. Opposing Torgny Mogren in the anchor leg, another Soviet Olympic champion, Alexei Prokhorov, who won the 30-kilometer race 7 days earlier. Torgny Mogren is not happy racing the anchor leg. In Calgary, he's been ill and racing poorly. He asked Coach Pettersson to let him ski in an earlier position. But Coach Pettersson's decision is firm. Torgny Mogren will ski the anchor leg.
Yeah, because he don't feel so strong the race before. It was the same for him as it was for me, so he don't know if he was strong enough.
During the relay, each of the four skiers will enter the stadium twice. Once at 5 kilometers, and again at the end of their 10-kilometer leg when they touch off to their teammate. Sweden wears number one, the Soviet Union number two. Once the race gets into its later stages, the leaders in the race can be confusing to the spectators. Often, it will appear that skiers are battling it out with the leaders when in fact they are a lap behind. Regardless of what happens on this first leg, it is expected that the race is between two countries, Sweden and the Soviet Union. There is added drama when the King and Queen of Sweden arrive at the stadium to watch the race. In the opening stages, a surprise. Andy Grunenfelder of Switzerland, an outstanding skier at longer distances, takes the lead. Jan Ottosson of Sweden is second, and Vladimir Smirnov of the Soviet Union third. Smirnov was expected to touch off first by virtue of his bronze and silver medal performances in the 15 and 30 kilometer races earlier in the week. But Grunenfelder of Switzerland skis a superlative leg. He arrives at the 10 kilometer mark with a 9 second lead over Ottosson of Sweden and Smirnov of the Soviet Union. Now the second leg. The revered Tomas Vossberg of Sweden will be opposed by Sakhnov of the Soviet Union. Quickly, they overtake Jörg Kapol of Switzerland. For Tomas Vossberg, Calgary will be his final Olympic Games. In 1980 at Lake Placid, he won the 15-kilometer race and came back 4 years later in Sarajevo to win the 50 kilometers. He also was part of the victorious relay team in Sarajevo, and now he is going after his fourth gold medal. He has been an inspiration and idol for the Swedish team, even though the torch of greatness has been passed to Gunde Svan.
We are so different persons, I think, but we are the same when we are on the ski tracks and so. But now I know how he felt when I came up and began to beat him, and now it's younger again who came and want to beat me. And it was the same when I like to beat Tomas Vossberg.
Tomas Vossberg and Vladimir Sakhnov quickly leave the pack behind on the second leg. Switzerland fades badly and Czechoslovakia moves up into third place. But the pre-race predictions prove correct. A head-to-head duel between Sweden, the Olympic champion, and the Soviet Union, the silver medalist in Sarajevo. Neither man will give ground. Waiting for them at the start of the third leg, two of the greatest cross-country skiers in the world, Gunde Svan of Sweden and Mikhail Dibitiarov of the Soviet Union, the winner of the 15-kilometer race earlier in the week.
Of course, we have a strategy, but at the relay, everything can happen, and you don't can say we should do exactly like that, but you don't know how the other goes, and so you must think forward.
The pre-race plan of Swedish coach Pettersson is so far perfect. Vassberg, whose strength and endurance in the longer distances is well known, is asked to stay even with the leaders during this short 10-kilometer leg. This he has done. Now in the third leg, a classic duel where both countries know the race will be decided. Gunde Svan starts off less than a second behind Mikhail Dibityarov of the Soviet Union. Very quickly, Gunde Svan goes past the Soviet champion. Svan's mission is basic. He must open up the distance between himself and Dibityarov. Behind the two leaders, the other countries are battling it out for the bronze medal. Czechoslovakia is third, Austria fourth, Switzerland fifth. Finland, the bronze medal winner at Sarajevo, is in seventh place, not in contention for a medal. As they approach the 5-kilometer mark and the first time into the stadium, Gunde Svan has opened a large lead over the Soviet champion. Gunde Svan is skiing the race that was expected of him earlier in the 15 and 30 kilometers. His times at the various checkpoints are the fastest of the day. Svan presses on, and there is nothing Dibityarov can do about it. Svan enters the stadium for the second and last time. He gives his teammate Torgny Mogren a 27-second lead. Mogren starts off for the final 10 kilometers. Prokhorov of the Soviet Union must wait for Dibityarov. Although Mogren's lead is exactly as planned, he is still concerned. He is still not sure of his physical condition. For him, there are as many psychological factors as there are physical. For he knows the Soviet champion will almost immediately start to cut down the distance between them. This is the privilege of the man in second place when he has the leader in his sights. For Mogren, he must ski his leg as planned and not panic as the Soviet skier comes closer and closer towards him. As each kilometer goes by, the distance between the two narrows. As they come into the stadium for the first time after 5 kilometers, the decision is still in doubt. Is receiving additional support. Gunde Svan has positioned himself on the course to urge his teammate on.
The Swedes in particular are quite a close team. They all get along well together. They all support each other. Every time one of the skiers was skiing a leg, all the other skiers from that team were running around, going from point to point to point on the course. And Gunde had run the third leg, and he was just going crazy on the last leg. He probably met Mogren about 8 times on different parts of the course.
As Prokhorov continues to cut down the distance, time is running out. Torgny Mogren is doing his job well. He has not panicked. He knows the victory is his.
The Swedes
Sweden defeats the Soviet Union by almost 13 seconds. For Gunde Svan, the relay victory was more emotional than 4 years earlier in Sarajevo.
I cannot explain what I feel because it's not so easy. I feel me so happy and it was like it should be again.
Five days later, Saturday, February 27th, the final of the 50 kilometers, a race approximately 31 miles. Like most cross-country races, the course is designed so that one-third is flat, one-third uphill, and one-third downhill. This race, too, has memories for Gunde Svan. 4 years earlier in Sarajevo, he won the silver medal, collapsing in exhaustion at the finish line, losing the gold medal by less than 5 seconds to his teammate, Tomas Vassberg. Vassberg is back to defend his title, the last race of his Olympic career. There are 74 starters. Vassberg will go off in the 39th position. Again, Gunde Svan has a good starting position. He is number 69 out of a field of 74. His main opposition will be on the course before he starts, and he will know what he has to do to beat them. A little less than 35 minutes after the first skier goes off, it is Gunde Svan's turn. Although it is hard to see, the skiers are going faster than their counterparts who run the marathon in track and field. In world-class competition, a cross-country skier would complete the 26-mile, 385-yard marathon distance more than 20 minutes faster than the best marathon runners. Sweden's victory in the cross-country relay has rejuvenated Gunde Svan. He is psychologically and physically prepared for this most grueling of cross-country events. He now knows he has returned to the position expected of him before the Calgary Games began.
You don't can say so many hours you can train to be the best. And now I have trained so many years, so it's so natural. You don't think about that. It's a new day, and you should do it again.
At 15 kilometers, Gunde Svan is skiing magnificently, 41 seconds faster than anybody else who has gone before him.
Gunde has everything. He has a tremendous amount of drive. He has a tremendous amount of natural ability. And he's also just a big guy. He's strong for his size. So when he takes a step, he takes a step. When he takes a stride, he takes a stride.
When Svan reaches the 25 kilometer mark halfway through the race, he now knows who the competition is. He is 67 seconds faster than Andy Grunenfelder of Switzerland, the temporary leader still on the course. But another dramatic story is the man in third place. He is Maurilio Desault of Italy, who is challenging for one of the medals. Desault is 37 years old and did not begin cross-country competition until he was 19. 1 year before the Calgary Games, Desault amazed the ski world by winning the 50-kilometer world championship title. News has been received that Tomas Vassberg has left the course and has retired from the race. Gunde Svan methodically goes on. When he reaches the 40-kilometer mark with 10 kilometers to go, he has increased his lead to 1 minute and 28 seconds over Desault of Italy, who has taken over second place from Grunenfelder of Switzerland, who has just finished the course. Desault started 2.5 minutes in front of Gunde Svan and reaches the finish before the great Swedish champion. As he crosses the line, he knows the silver medal is his. And only a major accident to Svan would give him the gold medal. But it is not to be. About a minute later, Gunde Svan approaches the finish. The victory is his. He has defeated Murillo de Zolf by 1 minute, 5 seconds. Gunde Svan has won his second gold medal here in Calgary. In 2 Olympic Games, he has won 4 gold, 1 silver, and 1 bronze medal. A little later, Gunde Svan stands on the top step of the victory platform as the Swedish national anthem is played for the second time here in Calgary.
You don't have time to think then, because you don't can explain how it feels.